What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, you just saw a quick unboxing on the ThinkEdge SE50 from Lenovo. There's a lot of items inside that box, so let's get to it. All right, so we have the ThinkEdge SE50 setup guide. Cool. We have the safety and warranty guide. Awesome. We have our DC power connector. Really strange when we go over some of the ports and features on this guy right here. We have two wireless antennas. We have some caps. Now, these caps are to actually block some of the ports, which we will go over soon on the device. We have four screws. Now, these four screws go with basically the plates, which allows you to mount it somewhere. You have an extra power connector, DC power connector. You have your power cable, as well as your power adapter. And your power adapter is actually 65 watts. So I'm actually gonna take the power adapter and the power cord and just plug it in. Awesome, cool. And it also comes with a USB mouse and also a full keyboard layout USB mouse. Pretty cool, all right? And then last but not least, we have the beautiful, ThinkEdge SE50. Now, this SE350, thickness-wise, is around 2.77 inches, and it is a, you know, it's a beast, right? But one of the things that I kind of find out when you take it out the box and you look at it, it doesn't have any ventilation, so it's fanless, right? Now, it's really weird to know what's front and back on the SE50, and the reason why I say that is because, like, where the power button is at, the power DC connector is right there. So you would normally think that this guy would be in the back, but it isn't, right? So it's really hard to tell you what's back and front, what's left and right. But if you have the device this way to the point that you are able to see the power button, right? On the right-hand side, you are going to see two slots for antennas that allows you to plug in two wireless antennas. And then on your left-hand side, you have three ports, right? On this particular model, we have on your left and your right, or your right and left, we have two little drops that allows you to connect your wireless antenna, which I'm gonna do right now with you guys. And it is that simple. All right, and we're gonna do the other side. Awesome. That's it. How simple was that? All right, so if you have the device facing like this, you have your power button, you have your mic jack, you have your audio jack, and you also have your SIM card slot, and you have a 3.1 USB connector. And then last but not least, you have your DC power connector right here. Now, if we turn it around, we have a lot of ports. Up top right here, you have two serial ports. You have your display port, a 3.1 USB port, your HDMI. You have your two 2.0 USB ports. And then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Ethernet ports, RJ45 ports. So that's a lot of RJ45s on this particular guy. Okay, so we are going to set up a monitor, an HDMI monitor, our keyboard, our mouse, and we're gonna power it on and let's get right into it. Okay, so we got the ThinkEdge SE50 hooked up with a keyboard, mouse, and an HDMI monitor. Again, you are able to hook up a display monitor, but it's up to you. You could have two monitors, a display and a HDMI. And we also have the power adapter hooked up, which is weird because, again, it's in the front where the power button is at. You would think it would be in the back where the Ethernet ports are at, but hey, that is the design for this ThinkEdge SE50. So the power button is located right here. I am going to press it to boot this machine up. And from there, we are going to look at the specifications and look at the performance, a couple of things that I did on this machine to test it out, and let's get right into that. All right, so the ThinkEdge SE50 finally booted up into Windows 10. One of the things that I noticed on this particular machine is that it does not have an internal sound system. So that means you have to either have a monitor with speakers and just make sure you go into your sound system and just you switch it to the monitor so you get audio, or you could take advantage of the audio jack and get some external speakers, but it does not have any internal speakers at all. Now for performance, let's take a closer look on performance. Now on the desktop, I'm gonna right click on the taskbar. We are going to go into Task Manager. Within Task Manager, I'm going to click on More Details. I'm going to go to Performance. I'm going to open up the Task Manager up a little bit. Let's right click on the CPU. Change the graph into logical processors. Now the ThinkEdge SE50 is actually running an Intel Core i7-8665UE CPU with a clock speed of 1.70 gigahertz. It has one socket, four cores, eight logical processors. For memory, right now it has 32 gigs, and it is also housing a solid state drive, which is around 256 gigs. And for the graphics, it has a Intel Ultra HD Graphics 620. Now this machine is classified for edge computing, and the way that I was testing it was basically running Premiere, Photoshop, VM Workstation. I was running all those programs and it worked flawless. All the specifications that this machine has, it just works really well. I was trying to game on this particular little guy. I call it like the mini Mac, right? Because it looks like a mini Mac. And gaming sucks. Again, it is running an Intel Ultra HD Graphics 620. A lot of lag. I thought it was probably going to get a good performance with the specifications, but it was just horrible. It was to the point that I couldn't really do any particular attacks. Within Jump Force, when I was playing that, it sucked. Now, when I was doing video editing, I was able to edit raw 4K files with no problems without creating any proxy files. That was a huge plus. Using Media Encoder to render out, it was pretty quick. I was pretty satisfied with the performance on the SC50 with my workflow with dealing with, you know, Media Encoder, Premiere, and also creating virtual machines within VM Workstation. I think one of the things that I definitely would like to do is bump up the memory so I could create more virtual machines and also bump up the hard drive. Now, because the ThinkEdge SE50 is fanless, this guy gets extremely hot. I think the temperatures that I got was between 110 to 120. I think the highest was around 120, 119. It gets really hot around this area. So it's really odd when you want to plug in stuff and the first thing that you want to do is you want to hold the computer to plug something in, and then all of a sudden it gets hot and you burn yourself. You have to be extremely careful around this area because, and they also give you a nice little warning, it gets hot, right? Now I did have the machine running for a lot of hours, maybe 3 or 4 or 5 hours. I did not hear any noise at all. Super surprised on that, but it is pretty silent. It's pretty efficient. Only thing that I'm concerned is that it gets hot. All right, so let's conclude our review on the ThinkEdge SE50. It's classified as an edge computing machine, but the way that I was testing it wasn't really producing data fast, but I was doing my workflow, you know, using Premiere, using a VM Workstation, encoding and rendering out raw 4K files. It just worked with no problem. Gaming, I don't really advise that you do gaming on this machine. Now, price-wise, it is around $2,400. You won't see this guy advertised on the Lenovo site. The $2,400, I got that price tag at CDW. So I think Lenovo is no longer selling it at their site, which kind of sucks because it's a great little machine that you're able to mount it, hook it up with two display monitors, and just, you know, kind of like present stuff like your data and stuff. Size-wise, it is extremely small. With a thickness of 2.77 inches, you are able to just put it anywhere. I just kind of recommend inserting it into a LAN room with a AC unit because, again, it gets extremely hot, around 120 degrees. That's the highest that I got on this machine. Overall, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed this review on the ThinkEdge SE50 from Lenovo, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.